Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. Today we are going to be starting a new project. So this is going to be the LightCanon flashlight. So this is going to be a custom made flashlight using aspheric lenses, and it's going to be made specifically to be a far throwing flashlight. So that means beam distance as far as possible. And to start off, I have a bunch of parts over here, some ordered from online, some bought from stores, some I already had, and I'm going to go through all the parts I have here, and there's also some parts which I still need to buy. So first of all, let's start off with the prototype. So over here is a flashlight. This is basically a tube with an aspheric lens on it and a regular flashlight inside. This is my old Phoenix TK41 flashlight, 800 lumens. It used to have a reflector, and it uses an Cree XML-U2 LED that puts out 800 lumens, and the beam distance was about 400 something meters. So what I did is I removed the reflector and the front lens, de-domed the LED, put on some, basically some foam over here and rings just to keep it in place, and then basically just slide it into the tube. And the lens at the end focuses the light so that it can concentrate into a very small point. And that's what makes the beam distance go so far. I have some pictures of this flashlight reaching about 800, 900 meters distance and still having a visible spot.
Improvements over the regular flashlight. Yeah.
But we're going to go further today. We are going to try to make something to go over about 1,500 to 2,000 meters. And it's going to be a long project, so don't expect this to be done instantly. But yeah, it's going to be a series of videos. So to start off, over here you can see we have a bunch of lenses. I might make a video later on how to choose a lens for your aspheric flashlight. There's different sizes, different curvatures, focal lengths, a bunch of stuff you need to consider. But a very popular lens is this 100 millimeter aspheric lens from Fast Tech. Link in the description for most of these parts. Fast Tech lens. It's not a very high quality lens. It's cheap, about $8, but it works, and a lot of people have used this to make very powerful throwers, and got this along with some other ones just for testing. But for this flashlight, we're going to be using this 100 millimeter lens. Next we have a V10 plus tiny LED driver. This is a 5 amp driver. I'm not completely sure if the final version of the flashlight will be using this one, but I've seen people use this one and it works, so I decided to get this also from Fast Tech, less than $10. Most of these parts here are very cheap. Over here we have some from, I think, Mountain Electronics. This is a Cree XP-G2 LED, and the reason why we have to use this is because the XML-2 is bigger, and when this LED is bigger, then the spot is going to be bigger and the light is not going to be so concentrated, therefore not having a throw that's very far. So smaller LED is better, and this is mounted on an octagon, I think this is a copper plate, but you can also use a sink pad. They're especially designed to dissipate a lot of heat, because when you drive these up to 5 amps, which these are only supposed to be driven at 1.5, they get really hot. So you need to have proper cooling. And I have a couple here. This is S42B. I have a spare one here, S20D. They're basically just different colors. And over here we have a heat sink. I'm not actually going to be using this one, but I will be using something very similar. This is a computer heat sink. And LED will go right there in the center, and then it will have a fan on the other side, so I'm going to get a bigger one so we can have some better cooling for this. Over here, we have a Wavian large color. So this is a special, specially engineered reflector made for LEDs and to increase the brightness of the LED, therefore making the throw farther. So very well packaged. This is what the large color is. Basically a spherical, perfectly spherical reflector made of glass with a 60 degree aperture, 30 degree half angle. So that means with the LED right here, I'm gonna have 30 degrees of light that way, 30 degrees this way, total of 60 degrees. And that means that more of the light is being focused forward onto the lens rather than spilling out the sides and hitting the inside of the tube, which basically will do nothing other than cause rings and distortion. So yeah, these are not cheap. This large one is $70, the medium is $60, and small is $50, but they are very high quality and a professional tool for people making these long-range flashlights. Just gonna put this back in the box. It's very well packaged. The stuff from Fastech coming from China was not so well packaged inside a basically a bubble wrap envelope with just these here, very unprotected. But luckily, everything I got was perfectly fine. Nothing was broken. So yeah, next over here, you've got some of my cables. I'm gonna be using these. This is this special high voltage cable, which I got from a projector, but I'm just using it because it has some very nice insulation and it's low resistance. Also got the heat protective sleeving on it. So those will be for the LED, and then a bunch of, I think these are 10 or no. 14 gauge RC power cables, so we're going to be using this for the power delivery. And finally, the flashlight. This is the flashlight. It is huge. This is a 100 millimeter PVC sewer pipe. Originally I bought a 10 foot long piece and I had to cut it to size, and this here is about 400 millimeters long, 40 centimeters, and it is very big. You can see compared to this already large tube, this thing is huge. And for comparison, let's see, what do I have for comparison? Here's the LED for comparison. And here's a watch for comparison. So yeah, very big, and got a couple parts over here. I've already started making measurements. Inside is this piece. It has a small inner part and then a large outer part. The outer part fits perfectly in the wide end of this tube. And then I think the inner part fits in the small end of the tube. So it's basically just a type of connector, but what we're going to use this for is to hold the lens. So you can see there's this ridge on the inside. This 100 millimeter lens fits perfectly in here, like that. You can see we got the lens in there, and this is acting sort of like a shroud, and it's going to be able to hold the LED. And this is going to help for focusing. So we have this piece in here, goes in the front, you can move it forward and back a little, and that's going to help to adjust the focus, make it perfect. And yeah, so that's a piece inside there. This piece at the back is just going to be an end cap. This is where the fan is going to go. So fan is going to blow air through this entire tube. And this is just going to hold it in place. We can remove it, take stuff out, and then put the lid back on. So 4 inch, 100 millimeter. Alright, so continuing with the flashlight, I have some markings over here which are going to indicate where each of the pieces is going to go. So there's a small mark over here. This is where the lens is going to be. A bit of the distance from the front, so that looking from the side you can't see a bright light shining. That will keep some of the light out. And 15 centimeters away is another mark all the way over here. This is going to be where the LED is. So the lens has a focal distance of about 14 centimeters, and by putting the LED 15 centimeters away from here, since we have about 2 centimeters of focusing, we can have basically the focal distance right in the center plus minus 1 centimeter, just to get the perfect distance. And then over here, about 6.5 centimeters away, is another mark. This is where the heatsink is going to be. So it's a pretty thick heatsink that's going to cool down the LED, and it's going to take up all of this. And then we got about 10 to 15 centimeters left from here to the end. And this is going to be where all the stuff like the switch, the charging port, the LED driver, battery and cables, and the fan is going to go. So all that stuff is going to be in the back part over here. So there's still some stuff which I am missing, of course. That's why this is still empty. I still need to get the heatsink, fan, and I think that's pretty much it. I need some thermal adhesive to stick the LED on the heatsink and the battery. And after that, we can get started to build this thing. So, yeah, it's pretty simple. PVC is a great material to build flashlights out of. Very easy to work with. But you do need to have good cooling, since this is not going to dissipate any heat. But, yeah, that's going to be the flashlight. So, I'm currently working on a 3D model of it, so you can get a better idea of what it's going to look like finished. But that's pretty much everything I have for now. Just one last thing over here. This. And this is a special material. Sort of like paper, but has a velvet coating on it. And this is basically called blackout paper. I'll just give you guys a peek over here. I don't want to get it dirty or anything. But it's a very dark black paper. And this is going to go on the inside of the flashlight part over here, so that any reflections, stray light, and all the extra light from the LED doesn't get sent through the lens at the wrong angle, and that's going to keep the inside dark, and that will help keep rings out of the LED, the light emitted from the LED. So yeah, this is going to go on the inside of the flashlight. That's basically all the parts I have for now. I'm going to start working on the wiring. I think the switch is going to need to go here at the back, since we only have this much space for the electronics. The switch is going to need to go here. And I'm going to have a special charging port so that we can charge the battery without having to take it out of the flashlight. Next part of this build log, we are going to install the lens and hopefully the heatsink as well. So yeah, look forward to that, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.